Hi, and welcome to our look at the beautiful town of Sandwich in Kent. You've heard the name, now let's look at the place. And if you like what you see, then why not subscribe so you catch more of our travels. And if you didn't know, Sandwich is in the county of Kent in the southeast corner of the UK, once an ancient Cinque Port when the landscape looked very different. And we'll explore this historic town, which is just over an hour and a half from London by train. And we're going to focus on the area that we've got shaded on the map in front of us. So without further ado, let's go and explore Sandwich. And we're going to start at the quayside, where there's an adequately sized car park. And throughout town, you'll find these information boards in both English and French. And you'll notice the town's coat of arms is that of the Cinque Ports, with Sandwich being one of the original five historic ports. It can be hard to believe now when you look at the course of the River Stour as it runs through Sandwich, and ships leaving here would have sailed directly into the English Channel, with the Isle of Thanet being some way in the distance to the northeast. But time and tide have changed that, and now it looks a lot more peaceful. And it's from here you can take out trips to go seal watching. I'll drop a link to that in the description below. And on our visit, we also noticed P-22, a relic from the Cold War. American designed, built in West Germany to patrol the waters between the east and west of the divided country. In the 17th century, Sandwich was a major port for immigration to the American colonies, with the corporation paying grants for people to settle in Virginia. And I've lifted that directly from that earlier information board I pointed out. And there's more links to America, which we'll discover a little later as we explore Sandwich. And as you can see, we've crossed the River Stour and gone across the old toll bridge. Don't worry, you don't need to pay to go across it now. From the bridge you get great views of the River Stour, the Bell Hotel and restaurant, and the 14th century Barbican Gate. The Bell Hotel is from the late 19th century, but there's been a bell inn on this spot from around about the 14th century, the same time as the Barbican Gate. And in the Barbican, the toll collector lived. And if you look, you can see how much your toll would have been. And joining the Barbican is the Crispin Inn, from the 16th century, although altered in the 18th century, so much, much later. But for one second, don't think Sandwich is old-fashioned. It's not. And next to the Crispin Inn is the Admiral Owen, a 15th century tavern. As you can see, there's plenty of places to get fed and watered, but don't worry, it's not all pubs, as we'll see a little later. And now we head down Strand Street, which gives you a fascinating insight into medieval England. And it's here you can find another one of those historic Sandwich information boards that give you a lot more detail and colour on the history of Strand Street and how Dutch refugees fleeing religious persecution brought their own skills to Sandwich. And we'll see more of the Dutch influence as we head through town. And as we're in Sandwich, I guess I need to touch on that food stuff. Now, as you probably know, it wasn't created in Sandwich, nor was Sandwich named after it. It was the creation of John Montagu, the 4th Earl of Sandwich, who wanted to eat a quick bite, so ordered some meat between two slices of bread. Whether that was at a gambling table or not, I'm not one to judge. And to our left is still the quayside, and along here you'll find cafes and bakeries where you can grab a bite to eat too. And behind that wall is the old King's House, where it's said Henry VIII watched his fleet depart for the field of the cloth of gold in 1520. And continuing along Strand Street, we pass St Mary's Church and the King's Arms Hotel. And there's plenty of little side streets to tempt you, but we're staying true to Strand Street. And it's becoming a little bit more late Georgian, Victorian. And we're going to continue along Strand Street until we reach the end of it, and the total distance from the Crispin and the Atmeline is only about half a mile, so it's not that long. And then we come across this unusual creation, which is made from old materials, but is relatively modern. This has taken us to the old town wall, the Butts. And we're going to take this path and head back towards the centre, passing Sandwich Town Cricket Club on the way. Now we could follow the Butts all the way along to the Rope Walk, Mill Wall, and then the Wall Walk, following the lines of the old city walls. But we're not, we're turning into Loop Street. And here you come across the old cottage from the 15th century, in between a lot more modern buildings. Here you're becoming a real time traveller. And now we step into Delft Street. Once again, the links with the Dutch are there. And this won't be the last time, I promise you. One of the things I love about Sandwich is it's not that big, and it's lovely to wander around and explore. The great thing is, you're close to the Kent coast, but you're not in a seaside town. I'll pop up a link at the end so you can see where else you can visit when you're in the area. And how about this for a touch of nostalgia? The old Empire Cinema, still showing films. And our stroll along Delft Street has taken us into New Street, and we've now hit the town centre. Delft Street does continue until it runs into King Street, and an interesting fact is, within the realms of the old town wall, I couldn't find any roads. They're all streets, lanes, courts, rows, just like the City of London. And again, there's quirky little features, like on our left, the 1920s former ticket office for the East Kent Road Car Company, which actually run buses. Just out of interest, have we tempted you to visit Sandwich yet? I'd be really interested, leave us a comment below. There's that guild hall again, built in 1579, but encased in brick in 1812, so you see nothing of the original building from the outside, although from the inside there are signs of it. It's also home to Sandwich Town Museum. I'll pop a link in the description below for more details. It's also on this square that you'll find the sandwich shop. Well, someone had to do it, didn't they? This square used to be the old cattle market. Well, opposite is the no-name shop and bistro. Now, don't think they were unimaginative. It's actually on No Name Street. There you go. There's that tiny little street. That's it, No Name Street. Now, a little further up New Street is number 20, the home of Thomas Paine, who authored The Rights of Man, that inspired the American Declaration of Independence. There's a lot of history in this sleepy little town. And once again, tempted to wander off and explore. But no, I need to head back to New Street. And as I said, this is a historic old town, but it's not set in the past. Look at this. Roadside electricity charging points. There's also another charging point within the Guildhall Civic Car Park too. We continue up New Street until we come to Galliard Street, which then leads into the chain King Street. And we follow King Street. Still no roads. And here we come across more historic buildings, including the Dutch House. See, they get everywhere. And doesn't it feel like you've stepped back in time? I almost feel like I'm in a period drama. What does it remind you of? Now that over there is Short Street. I'm becoming obsessed. And I'm surprised Sandwich hasn't appeared in more TV dramas. It seems quite unspoiled in places. So now we're at King Street and St. Peter's Street, and we're going to follow St. Peter's Street. It's along here you'll come across the old town jail, and right next to it is the church. And across from the church is Holy Ghost Alley, so we've gotta have a look. And this leads us to the High Street, and if we follow this down towards the water, it'll take us towards the Barbican Gate we saw earlier. But we're going to head back down Holy Ghost Alley towards St. Peter's Church, which is now a community hub. And inside it you can find second-hand items for sale to help support the upkeep of the church. It's also possible to climb the tower as well for a small fee. Now, why didn't I do that? The church tower is also home to the curfew bell, which rings at 8 p.m. every evening, the start of the curfew. Don't worry, it's not enforced. And in the garden is a memorial to Augustus Charles Newman, recipient of the VC. And just outside is the town's war memorial. We're just taking a little double back to King Street, opposite the church, and taking a little peek down here till it joins Market Street. Once again, Sandwich keeps on giving its delights with the wonderful architecture along Market Street. Straight in front of us, Market Street turns into the Butchery, and to the right, it turns into Potter Street. I guess in times past you knew exactly what you were going to get. And for us, now let's head down Potter Street. Sandwich, you know you're not going to get lost, and in no time at all we find ourselves back on Strand Street. And we're heading back to the Quayside, but we've got one last thing to look at, and that is the medieval Fisher Gate. So at this point I'd like to say thanks so much for watching, I really appreciate it. If you like what you've seen, then don't forget to hit subscribe and click on that notification bell, we'd really appreciate it, and give us a like, it helps us a lot. And now, here's that Fisher Gate.